Hello guys, welcome back. My name is Nathan, and today I'm gonna be doing my final 2020 NHL mock draft simulation. Now, the Tampa Bay Lightning officially winning the Stanley Cup, we now have the official first round and the top 31 picks all in order. And that begs the question, which prospects do I think will go in the top 31 of this first round, and how do I see each pick going in the first round of the 2020 NHL draft? Watch till the end for all my picks and all my predictions, and of course, hit that big red subscribe button for more videos just like this one. And now getting us started with the first overall pick in the New York Rangers, and just like the time before this, and the time before that, and the time before that, and the time before that, Alexis Lafreniere will be a New York Ranger, and there's no difference here in my pick today. Great fit, I think, for the Rangers. Will automatically get a top six spot, I think, on that left wing side, and I think will be pretty good, potentially even winning the Calder Trophy. I think Kirill Kaprizov will give him a run for his money, but those two, I think, are going to be the mainstays next season for the Calder. Going to number two and the LA Kings. This is one of the more interesting picks, I would say, out of number one. Tim Stützle, the German winger, is who I still go for. Even though I think Quinton Byfield is the better prospect, and that's who I would take number two, Tim Stützle is just a solid fit for the LA Kings all around. Can add some amazing skill to not just that prospect pool, but that team in general. And once he's ready with the uprising guys like Turcotte and Kupari and Vilardi and all these different players, I think he's going to be the best prospect on that team potentially, and could be on the LA Kings maybe to start out next season. Then going on to number three of the Ottawa Senators, and at this spot they kind of have to select Quinton Byfield, and man, I sure hope they do, and I think they will. Quinton Byfield coming in number three, fantastic pick for the Sens. Number one center of the future, might not be completely NHL ready, but a player that can provide some excellent value, a guy that could at his peak do almost everything for you and give you as much value as possible. That to me will be a serious add for the Ottawa Senators and could be their next franchise face. Then going on to number four, we haven't seen any changes yet until now, and I think the Detroit Red Wings will select Canadian Cole Perfetti. I think Cole Perfetti has been linked to Detroit, but it's not just that. I've had heard some things that Detroit is looking at Cole Perfetti, and we have had some rumors about that as well. To me, it's between Cole Perfetti and Lucas Raymond for Detroit. I could see either of those two guys being selected, but I think Cole Perfetti just makes more sense for the Detroit Red Wings. Personally, I would go Lucas Raymond, but Perfetti already has a link there. I think that's a player that can provide some excellent value potentially on that first line of the future, and it's been reported that they see Perfetti as a potential Marner-like offensive weapon, and that's pretty high praise. So for Detroit, I think Perfetti is their pick, and that's who they'll go for. That leaves a very interesting pick for the Ottawa Senators at number five. Now, we heard a rumor from Jeff Merrick that within the organization, the Sens are looking at Jack Quinn, Askarov, and Sanderson with the fifth overall pick. And you know what? I think Jeff Merrick is a solid guy. Again, has the 31 Thoughts podcast with Elliot Freeman, so he has some sources. But I think Ottawa is putting a little bit of a smokescreen out there of that, and I think they will select number five, Lucas Raymond. Now, I had them selecting Perfetti number five last time, and I think if Raymond is available, they will go for him. I think this is just a perfect fit for the Sens, especially after getting Quinton Byfield. This pick might be different if it is Tim Stützle at number three they go for, because they might not go for another winger, but I think with Byfield as the top line center of the future, you get Lucas Raymond, who can also be a top line player of the future, I think. And those are two beautiful picks. I have Lucas Raymond number four, and I have Quinton Byfield second in my rankings. So you get what plus one on each of those picks. Lucas Raymond at number five, I think will be a brilliant fit for that franchise. Then going on to number six, I have from the Anaheim Ducks, Jamie Drysdale. And I think this is just a perfect fit for the Ducks the more I think about it. There's a few players also that I could see the Ducks going for. Holtz, Rossi as two forwards I think would be great fits too. But I think defense is where the Ducks are going to go hard in this draft. And I think Jamie Drysdale is a guy that can provide that value. Personally, I would take Marco Rossi if I'm Anaheim in terms of the most value possible. But Jamie Drysdale is still an excellent fit and offensively will bring big time punch to that defense. Then going on to number seven in the New Jersey Devils, Elliot Freeman said they might go for Askarov at this pick. I'm not going to have them getting Askarov because if they do, my boy Blackwood, I'm going to freaking throw hands. But Blackwood to me is absolutely the starter of the future and the now. So I think they will go for the big time goal scorer, Alexander Holtz. Once again, I think this is a beautiful fit for the New Jersey Devils. You put him alongside of Nico Hischier, and I think, That would just be absolutely beautiful. Then going on to number 8 in the Buffalo Sabres, I think they have to go for Austrian center Marco Rossi. And I think this just makes way too much sense. I think they will go for the best player available. We have heard some ways that they might want to move that pick. But if they stay at number 8, they get Marco Rossi, an amazing second line center of the future. You have Jack Eichel, Marco Rossi, and potentially Dylan Cousins on the wing. That is freaking nasty. Then going on to number 9 from the Minnesota Wild, I see them going for Yaroslav Askarov. Now, personally, I would put my faith in Kaapo Kähkönen, and they already had a goaltender last year in the second round in Hunter Jones, but I feel like Askarov is a pick that they'll want to go for high. They already have quite a bit of stuff on their defense in both in the NHL roster and a couple of prospects in deep. And on the forward group, you got some excellent options, especially on wing. If they aren't able to get Anton Lindell, I could definitely see them going Askarov, but I feel like Askarov is the pick for them. Anton Lindell, again, would be another great option, I feel, but you get the solid goaltender of the future. And we've heard a lot of different times that Askarov going outside of the top 10 is looking more and more unlikely. And I think a team like Minnesota is a pretty good bet to make in terms of that pick. And now going from the Minnesota Wild to the Winnipeg Jets at number 10. And with Anton Lindell available, I think there's no question they go for the Finnish center, Anton Lindell. To me, Anton Lindell is definitely one of the more underrated players in this draft class, and in my opinion, has the potential to win a Selke trophy in the future. I mean, Winnipeg's looking for a 2C right now, but if you're looking for a 2C in the future, that can be an absolutely perfect one. Anton Lindell is definitely that, can bring some much needed defense on that forward core, and can pretty much do it all. Not at a super high level, but all the basics are there, all the fundamentals are there, and it's just sweet to see. For me, Anton Lindell is one of my favorite players in this draft, and at number 10, not a bad pick for the Jets. Then going on to number 11, I see the Nashville Predators selecting Jake Sanderson. There's a couple other prospects I could see them going forwards, maybe Seth Jarvis or Jack Quinn, but I think Jake Sanderson being available at number 11, that's what the Preds will go for. They don't really need defense right now, but Matthias Ekholm is 30 years old, and he's on that left side, which will be where Jake Sanderson will be. And I think by the time Sanderson is ready, the Preds defense will start to maybe transition to guys like Fabro, guys potentially like Sanderson, and we'll start to see more of youth on that blue line. I think Sanderson is a good fit, and honestly, in terms of where he's projected to go, 11 might be a little bit low in terms of where he could go on draft day. Then going on to number 12 and the Florida Panthers, and I personally see them still going for a forward, and that guy will be Jack Quinn. Awesome goal scorer, and I think he has the potential to be a 30, maybe even 40 goal scorer if he's paired with the right center. But that's the type of guy that has some dynamic ability to him. Is definitely on the older side of this draft class, but a player I think the Florida Panthers can mold quite well. Then going on to number 13 in the Carolina Hurricanes, and at this spot I had a scare up going here last time around, but obviously he's not available. And I think they will go for the Russian winger in Rodion Amirov. I think this is a brilliant fit. Amirov's been solid so far in the KHL as well, and I think that's a player that the Canes would love to have on that left wing. You could have your top two left wingers as Svechnikov and Rodion Amirov, and that is pretty beautiful in my opinion. Amirov as a pretty much perfect second line left winger right there for the Canes. Going at number 14, I think the Edmonton Oilers will select winger Seth Jarvis. I see this as a pretty solid fit, and I feel like last time around I had them selecting Lucas Reichel, but if Seth Jarvis is available, I see them going for him. I think Jarvis would be a perfect fit on the Edmonton Oilers on that right wing, could do so much damage, and they aren't afraid to draft smaller forwards, guys like Kaylor Yamamoto, who especially this past season have worked out quite well. And I think Seth Jarvis is a guy that you put alongside McDavid, you put alongside Draisaitl would just be perfect fits. Then going on to number 15 in the Toronto Maple Leafs from the Pittsburgh pick, and at this spot I still see them selecting Braden Schneider. We could see this pick moved potentially, but I feel like Schneider's just a solid fit all around for the Toronto Maple Leafs. In terms of value, I wouldn't pick Schneider here, but I feel like the Toronto Maple Leafs will go for a guy who can provide some good defensive play, can provide some excellent physical play as well. He will be a little more of a long-term project, but could cap out as a fourth defenseman, which for Toronto, they could definitely use right now. Then going on to number 6 in the Montreal Canadiens, and I had them last time around selecting Rodion Amirov. Sadly, not available at number 16 this time around, and at the moment I think they will select Dylan Holloway, left winger for the future, and of course teammates for Cole Caulfield this past season. Didn't really have the most impressive NCAA season, but as the year went on, he got a lot more just complete and started to actually look like a future middle six NHL player, which is what I think he can become. He might be a third line player at most, but I could see him becoming a second line utility player that can provide a lot of value. Wouldn't be my pick at number 16, but a pretty decent fit from the Montreal Canadiens, and they've already known him quite well, of course, with that Caulfield connection. Next up, going to number 17 in the Chicago Blackhawks, I have winger in Dawson Mercer. Same pick as last time, but I still see Mercer as an excellent fit for the Blackhawks. A guy who I could see as a pretty solid top six winger for the future. A guy that can do a lot of different stuff. And I think he's almost as complete as a winger as you can get. I don't think he's amazing in any one category. He just gets the job done and has some solid skill to boot, which I think for Chicago, they'll use quite well. Then going on to number 18 in the New Jersey Devils, at this spot with their Arizona pick, I think they will select Henriks LaPierre. I had them selecting Connor Azari last time around, but I think LaPierre, with his QMJHL season thus far, has proved a lot of doubters wrong, and so far is looking a lot more healthy. Obviously, these teams know more than we do, but so far this QMJHL year, he's looking as good as new, and is playing the best hockey he's ever played. So I feel like he'll go a little bit higher than people might expect. I think New Jersey will want to get him at this spot. Potentially a third line center of the future, but could be even more than that. You could maybe put him on the wing as well, but a brilliant playmaker, and I think could also, if you're looking at a long-term, work off Alexander Holtz as well. Then going on to number 19 and the Calgary Flames, and at this spot, I still see them selecting a Caden Gooley. Now, I think it's between Caden Gooley and Connor Zary for Calgary, two WHLers there, but I really don't see Caden Gooley going past the Flames. I think that's a solid player that will get drafted in this top 20. Personally, I wouldn't draft him top 20 at all, but I think Calgary can get some value from him, and as a top six defenseman, I think he has some decent potential there as a mobile, strong, physical defenseman. Then going on to number 20, and the New Jersey Devils once again, I still think will select, with the defenseman pick, Helgi Granz. I still think Helgi Granz is an amazing fit for the Devils. Swedish defenseman who has a lot of solid potential. I feel like that's one of the more safer picks in terms of defensemen, but even though he is on the safer side, I still love him quite a bit. He was one of the youngest defensemen in this draft class, and I think that's the type of player that can provide some amazing overall value. I don't think he is insane in any one category, but can do a lot of different stuff and add a lot of variety in his game. Then going on to number 21 in the Columbus Blue Jackets, and at this spot, I think they will select Connor Zary. Now, they already have quite a few centers in their system, but Connor Zary is a guy that can transition to wing if they so need to, and I think Connor Zary is a guy that still will go top 25 in this draft, and I think Columbus is a pretty good fit. Connor Zary is a guy that fits that mold of hardworking, intelligent players, and I feel like him on Columbus is kind of a match made in heaven. Then going on to number 22 in the New York Rangers, their second pick in this draft, and I think they will go for, sadly, with Henriks LaPierre gone, German Lucas Reichel. Now, another left winger, but a guy that can potentially play either wing. I think Lucas Reichel is a solid fit for the New York Rangers either way. I think that's a player that on the wings can provide some excellent value. And I feel like for Lucas Reichel, that's the type of player that would really develop well in New York system. Tending to more offensive style players, Lucas Reichel is a guy that I could totally see fitting right at home on that Rangers offense and being a mainstay on that middle six for a very long time. Here's hoping. Then going on to number 23, I have them selecting, Philadelphia selecting, I don't even know why I didn't say the team, John Jason Paterka. Now, back-to-back German selected, I think Paterka, again, is a solid fit for the Philadelphia Flyers. Another wing prospect, but they don't really have too many holes in their prospect pool. I think Paterka is a guy that can provide some excellent defensive value, and as a third line, maybe second line forward, a guy that can do quite well for the Flyers. Next up, going to number 24 and the Capitals, and at this spot, I think they will select, once again, Canadian defenseman Ryan O'Rourke. Now, I really see Washington going for a defenseman here. Their cupboards in terms of defensive prospects is just barren as all heck, and I feel like for Washington, getting a guy like Ryan O'Rourke is huge. Maybe a little bit of a reach, but I haven't been the late first round. I think that's a player that can provide some amazing value on that top four. Really intelligent, smart defender who I think went pretty underrated throughout the OHL season. Then going on to number 26, the St. Louis Blues, I think will also select a defenseman, this time being Tapio Nieminen. Now, Tapio Nieminen is a guy who definitely has one of the biggest floors in this draft class for defensemen, but I would say one of the lowest ceilings. But I really don't see St. Louis being too bothered by that. I think Tommy Nieminen will become a solid fifth, maybe fourth defenseman at the NHL level, but can provide some strong defensive game with some good physical play too. And I think for St. Louis, that's definitely what they're looking for. Then going on to number 27 on the Anaheim Ducks, from the Boston pick, I think they will select center Maverick Bork. Now, not a not a bad haul for the Anaheim Ducks, getting Jamie Drysdale and also Maverick Bork at 27. Bork is a pretty good pick here. Intelligent, solid all-around center who I think can provide some awesome play for the Ducks in the future. I don't think he's going to be anything more than a middle six player, but a guy that can do some awesome stuff. And I think has gotten a little bit underrated throughout this year. Had a solid QMJHL season, and I can't wait to see what he does with Anaheim if that pick goes through. Then going on to number 28 and the Ottawa Senators. Now, it has been reported that the Sens might move this pick, but if it stays at number 28, I think they will go for a defenseman, and that guy will be Emil Andre. Solid defensive player for the Swedish team, and I feel like for Emil Andre, he's one of the guys that we could see back on draft day as one of the more bigger steals of the draft. In terms of Emil Andre, I think he has some excellent potential. Just a solid skater all around. And I think that's the type of guy that has a pretty big ceiling for the Sens. Has one of the lowest floors in terms of defensemen, but I still think in the boomer bust category, just like a guy like William Wallander, I think that's the type of pick that the Sens will want to bet on. Then going on to number 29 of the Vegas Golden Knights, and speak of the devil, William Wallander, I think, is what the Vegas Golden Knights will go for. In terms of defensive value, even more than Emil Andre, this is one of the biggest boom or bust picks, I think, of this draft. William Wallander has the potential, I think, to be one of the best D-men of this draft, potentially even top three, but he also has the potential to become absolutely nobody. His offensive game is really sneaky good. The only real problem sometimes is his decision-making in some aspects. It can be really, really questionable. But the talent is undeniably there. And I think for the Vegas Golden Knights, that's a player that they can totally bet on for that defense on the future. Then going on to my Dallas Stars at number 30. And I think at that spot, I want them to go for Jacob Perreault, and I sure hope that that's the pick because it would be an amazing fit. The center slash right winger has some amazing offensive potential, and personally, I love his creativity so much, I would pick him in the top 20. That's just a player that I love the more I watch. Doesn't really fit too much in Dallas' system, which is why I want them to pick him, because he's such a solid offensive player, and I think would breathe a little bit new life into that prospect pool, I would say, and especially into that center core, potentially in the future. He might play right wing because Valandria might be a center, third line guy for them in the future, but I think either way, I mean, Perreault at number 30, not a bad pick. Then going out to our last one at number 31, and it would be Tampa's pick, but San Jose got it in the Goodrow deal, working out quite well for the Tampa Bay Lightning. And at number 31, I think the San Jose Sharks will select Lucas Cormier. Now, Lucas Cormier is a guy that goes pretty underrated in this draft also. Super, super solid in the QMJHL this year. I think that's a player that has so much intelligence, so much overall IQ, that I think for the San Jose Sharks, they would love to have him. Personally, I do hope they go for a defenseman because they have Ryan Merkley, but besides that, the prospect pool, it's really not too much, kind of barren. But Lucas Cormier will be a very solid guy and could be a really solid just plug in that top four spot, right after guys like Carlson and maybe Burns go on the wayside. But Lucas Cormier, solid pick at number 31. But that'll be it for today, guys. Thanks so much for enjoying and watching today's video. Make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit that notification bell if you are new. Comment down below your thoughts. What do you agree and disagree with? And who do you see your team taking? And how do you see some of these picks going in this first round? Make sure you share this video with your friends. Get it out there. Click this call right here for all my 2021 NHL draft content. My name is Nathan, and I'll see y'all next video or stream. Goodbye.